So I have two main parts of the belt that need ornamentation. One of them is coin, and then the other one is like a plate, which is a landscape sort of a design.
Think anyone's ever going to see all these details?
Nope, not at all. That's the blockout version of the plate. So I'm not exactly sure what I want to put on that. It could just be ornamental detail. It doesn't need to be like any, you know, specific Final Fantasy character of old.
Probably not, yeah.
Yeah.
Not sure about having a royal crown there though.
Yeah. That's, yeah, block out. So I'm thinking that's probably going to be Siren.
That's pretty cool. You think anyone's ever going to see all these details?
Nope, not at all. This was all, I wonder if I could do it. Let's just do it. And then I did it. And the good news is it only took me, you know, 2 days. So in terms of efficiency, no, not efficient at all. Probably won't be seen. But as like an interesting, possible interesting footnote I could throw into like my portfolio, maybe like in the Celis post, like, oh, by the way, did you notice Siren was there? By the way, I actually kind of sculpted her.
Yeah, I mean, as long as you're aware that you kind of wasted some time there, I guess everything's good and you can do whatever you want, really. But it could be like, it could turn eventually into a post. Yeah, it means you probably would have to go back and tweak it even more, but
yeah
it could be a nice thing to add to the portfolio for sure. Yeah.
Probably less of a post on its own and more just something as a footnote within the Celis post.
I think it's a good idea. Yeah. You can definitely find a pose here that's going to work well too and that won't necessarily ask you to tweak like a whole lot of stuff left and right. You know, like there's obviously angles here that don't work as well, but obviously, I mean, that was not the intention really. So, yeah. So, MRG BZ Grabber essentially, that's going to work great for this. I'm like, you may still have issues though. Like, MRG BZ Grabber is great, but if you have this big of a space, you're still going to get like a bit of a shady result though. Like, you're literally going to get this kind of elevation out of the mesh, if you will, you know, unless you've, I mean, this obviously won't come out with this much amplitude. You'd have to squish it down. Maybe it's going to look great. Maybe not, but
yeah. So I have two main like, parts of the belt that, need, you know, ornamentation. One of them is coin, that's what this is, and then the other one is like a plate, which is, you know, more of a landscape sort of a design. So I'm thinking I probably need, I don't know, just looking at the overall composition of the coin, I think I probably need a little bit more stuff in the upper left corner of it. But I was thinking of maybe literally just having text there that said Siren or something.
You shouldn't add detail just for the sake of it, but if you add something, it's because this element is missing from the overall composition, and without this, the character simply doesn't read, you know? That's kind of what you want to be doing there. I'm not seeing anything like other than like another wave maybe, you know? Like, and like you could obviously play around with these somehow, but this is starting to look very art nouveau there.
Yeah,
you know what I'm talking about there. Like, you're really starting to get a bit of a vibe of that, and they are like quite, like when you look at those pieces, like they often are like quite ornamental with like flowers and waves and all that stuff, you know? Like,
yeah, actually that specific artist that's in the third picture, Mooka, I want to make it as much like Mooka's art as possible. I actually learned a lot about Art Nouveau recently with actually going to this gallery of Mooka that they had in the town nearby. And basically they were saying like, oh yeah, apparently it was like an art movement that was like a reverse inspiration of Japanese woodblock art. And that could be why it almost reminds me a little bit of like anime in a way, in its like flatness.
Yeah, it's so nice. I do quite like it too. It's so nice to look at, you know, like in, like, it's a perfect counterpoint to like all the minimalism that's kind of going on right now everywhere. This is also a response to that in a way. Art movements always are kind of like a response to whatever movement was there before. But yeah, I really like this stuff too. Like, I feel as if you're gonna go for that though, you really need to go like all the way, you know, like need to add like leaves and you need to add like a whole bunch of stuff to this. That's kind of not there right now. Cause yeah, like, okay. Like this wave right now by itself, like it feels, even if you make it like as big as this, like truth be told, I'm not sure it's really satisfying that much because it's something that's too detailed, but that yet still doesn't take enough space. Like there's simply too much negative space, mm-hmm. you know? So like, I kind of like the idea of keeping this wave like really, really small, like what you had before, something like this. And then simply keeping this very devoid of information and really going for that kind of minimalist style, or do the opposite, go like really just all the way for like Art Nouveau and really like throw all the ornamentations in there that you can't imagine, you know? Like I feel as if the only thing that's important is that you don't like kind of make something that's kind of halfway, you know, because then
yeah
it's not gonna really like inscribe itself into anything really.
Art Nouveau is not about going halfway. But yeah, pretty much everything I made so far is literally just like a remake of what was there. And yeah, for them, they had the waves about that small. I could probably fit in maybe a little bit more water work. But yeah, I think after that, I think I'll probably move into just more ornamental stuff.
Yeah, it's nice. It's a great idea. This can definitely like even stand as a piece on its own, even completely detached from Celeste, you know, like as a portfolio piece. I'm still concerned though, time-wise though, like if this is worth the time to spend on, you know, like this kind of feels like one of those things of like, yeah, these are great ideas, this would be really fun to do, but at some point you may be doing this out of pure pleasure and not out of sort of like a disciplined approach to making this character in the smallest amount of time possible, because you are concerned about your deadlines and getting a job and all of these things, you know? Like, this kind of feels into one of those things that, like, at this point, you're really just doing it for yourself, you know? Like, and you're not really doing it for a practical purpose. You know, which is fine, but ultimately, like, are you tight on time, or do you have a lot of time free to explore and sort of indulge in these kind of things, you know?